factoring strategy. In this video, we are going to review what we have already learned about different factoring tricks and different ways to factor, and we're just going to kind of bring it all together and kind of figure out where to start when you first come to a factoring problem. So remember that you need to always, always, always factor the GCF first. There can be a lot going on in a factoring problem, but we want to handle this GCF first and make sure that we pull out any common factors. Okay, so then let's talk about what tricks we have, what strategies we have for other situations. So when we have two terms, we could be looking for something like the difference of squares. And remember that the difference of squares is where we start out with a squared minus b squared, and we break it down into something like a plus b times a minus b. We could also be looking for cubes, and in cubes we're going to have something like a cubed plus b cubed, or we could have a cubed minus b cubed. So if we had a plus, then down here, when we break it down, we would come up with a plus b, a squared, minus ab, plus b squared. Or if we had a minus sign up here, then this would change to a minus, and this would change to a plus. So I've just got these symbols here to say that it could be plus or minus, and in this case, we've got the plus on top and the minus on top, because the plus and the minus go together as part of the same formula. So, and in order to keep track of these signs, remember that we're using SOAP: same, opposite, and always positive. Let's talk about what our strategies are when we come across three terms. So it's possible with three terms that we might have a perfect square. So perfect square, remember, is going to be something like a squared plus or minus 2ab plus b squared. So we're looking for the beginning and end as being squares is a good hint that we want to use this strategy. And then got to double check that we've got our 2ab. And this is going to break down into a plus or minus b squared. Then we also have our reverse FOIL method, if we have three terms. And reverse FOIL, again, is kind of like when we were doing guess and check to try and figure out what in the world we could possibly break down our expression into. So if we had something like x squared minus x minus 12, that could break down into x plus 3 times x minus 4, and then we would want to FOIL all of these back together to see whether or not we have our original expression. And then when we come across an expression with four terms and we're asked to factor it, our main strategy there is going to be grouping. So grouping, remember from way long ago, so when we've got something like AB plus AC plus DB plus DC, then we draw a line down the middle and find a common factor on the front half, and then we find a common factor on the right hand side. Then we see whether or not we have any common factors across both, so that then we can come up with our b plus c times a plus d. Okay, so those are going to be our main strategies, and in this section we're just focusing on how do I know which method to use. So let's take a look at example one. In example one, I've got 25x squared minus 16. So first, it's going to be helpful for us to go ahead and count how many terms we have. So here, this is my first term, this is my second term. So then I can see what kind of methods do I use when I've got two terms. Difference of squares or sum or difference of cubes. So when I look at this example, it looks to me like I've got square number, variable squared, and another square number. So since these are squares and I've got two terms, this is going to have to be a difference of squares. Okay, so then let's go ahead and look at example two. How in the world do I even get started on this one? Well, let's go ahead and count our terms. Got one, two, three terms here. So with three terms, I'm going to be looking for either perfect squares or reverse FOIL. But it looks to me like this right here is not a square number, so I'm not going to be able to use my perfect squares. So instead, we're definitely going to have to do reverse FOIL on this one. And remember, reverse FOIL is like guess and check. Okay. So now, looking down at example three, which method would we use in this case? So count how many terms we've got. One, two, three, four terms. I've only got one method to help me with four terms, and that's going to be grouping. So my strategy here is going to be grouping. And then you should also remember that whatever strategy you're going to use in the long run, the first thing you want to do when you come to each of these problems is see if there's any common factor that you can pull out before you start your main factoring process.